Fine. So this is our paper. We will start with our discussion of our paper, right? So few things I need to also check, because we had seen CSV files long term ago. So I may refer to the textbook to see few things, right? So here it is, the sample question paper which we'll be having, and these are the general instructions. And please, I request you people to go through the general instructions very carefully before starting the paper. Okay, so here we have two parts, that is A and B. Each part is compulsory. Both part A and part B have internal choices. Part A has two sections. Section 1 is short answer questions, basically one word or one line questions. Section 2 has two case studies questions. Each case study has four case based subparts. An examinee is to attempt any four out of the five subparts. So B, part B is descriptive paper, that is mostly subjective questions are there, and three sections: short answer, long answer, very long, and Python language has to be used. So let's start. First, part A, section 1. Select the most appropriate option out of the options given for each question. So basically, it is a type of MCQ based question. Not all are MCQ. Some are simply one line or one word questions also. Attempt any 15 questions from question number 1 to 21. So you have to, out of 21 questions, you have to attempt only 15 questions. So please judge the questions carefully, and one very important thing, write the correct question number. Okay, do not write, go on writing the, it's not like you have attempted the first question, then the third question, and you are writing 1 and 2 as the question numbers. Please don't do that. Write the correct question number. Okay. Find the invalid identifier from the following. What is the invalid identifier? Let's check out each one of them in detail. So here we are. My name. This is absolutely correct. There is no problem with this one. Second is true. Is it a valid identifier? No, because true is a keyword which is used as a Boolean value. Next is second name. Is this valid?
No.
This is also not valid because it starts with a digit. So all concepts of 11th class are coming here. Okay. So students, you have to be very careful with this. You have to use all the, don't forget anything, because 11th and 12th, all the concepts are linked, right? This is from Python revision tour chapter. Okay. Next is my name. This is absolutely correct because it follows all the rules of naming identifiers. So this is 1 mark, half mark each correct answer. Okay. Next is given the list L, write the output of print L 2:5. So I'm going to just take a screenshot of it because we will be doing, or I'll do it here itself. This is 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right, and 2:5, that is we'll start from 6 and we'll end at 5. 6, 82, 5. This is going to be our answer for this, right? 6, 82, 5, that is 2, 3, and 5. Index locations 2, 3, and 5. Write the full form of CSV, very easy, comma separated value 5. Comma separated values, simple. Identify the valid arithmetic operator in Python from the following. Which operator is valid?
I'm exponentiation.
This is valid. What about, yes. Others are not. This is logical operator. This is relational operator. And question mark we don't have. Okay, next is, suppose a tuple T is declared as this. Which of the following is incorrect? Print T1. Now, here it is what? 0, 1, 2, 3. Print T1, which of the following they are asking is incorrect? So this is correct. Next is T2. is equals minus 29. This is item assignment in tuple, which is incorrect. Rest all are correct. Okay, item assignment is not allowed in tuples. Write a statement in Python to declare a dictionary whose keys are 1, 2, 3 and values are Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday respectively. So, you have to declare a dictionary. So, I am creating a dictionary here named weekday. And what they have asked is whose keys are 1, 2, 3 and values are Monday, Tuesday. So, 1. And so on, we will be doing till the last one, that is 7, Sunday. Simple, a very simple question where we have to just create, declare a dictionary. Kindly don't write any program for this. You have to be very specific about what is asked in the question. If it is a write a statement, it means only one single statement has been asked. Next, a tuple is declared as t equals this. What will be the value of sum t? So 2 plus 5, 7 plus 6, 13. Plus 9, it is 22. Plus 8, it is 30. Is it correct? Yes?
Yes,
ma'am. Sum t, are we going to get? We'll try it whether we have. I haven't used sum function. I think we should get the correct answer for that. Just a second. Yeah, I opened two. I'm just doing it here. T equals 2, 5, 6, 9, 8. And I'm writing here sum t. Yes, correct. Next is name the built-in mathematical function or method that is used to return an absolute value of a number. Minus 4. It is ab. ABS. Name the protocol that is used to send emails. Now see networking. Tell me, Anshika.
SMTP.
SMTP. Can anyone tell me the full form of SMTP? SMTP.
Simple mail.
Yes, simple mail transfer protocol. Fine, this is SMTP. Next, your friend Ranjana complains. Now, this is a HOTS. All are HOTS, but this is a HOTS. Your friend Ranjana complains that somebody has created a fake profile on Facebook and defaming her character with abusive comments and pictures. Identify the type of cyber crime for these situations. In my opinion, this cybercrime is known as a theft of identity or theft of private property. Next is in SQL, name the clause that is used to display the tuples in ascending order of an attribute. Which clause is used to display the tuples in the ascending order of an attribute?
Order by.
Order by clause, yes. In SQL, what is the use of is null operator?
to check whether the tuple has some value or not.
Yes, whether the it is empty or not. So if you want to check all those tuples which contain empty value, that is no value for a particular field, okay, so there we will be using is null. Write any one aggregate function used in SQL. Name any aggregate functions. What are the aggregate functions? We have count.
Average.
We have average.
Sum.
Sum, min, max. These are all the aggregate functions in SQL. Next is, which of the following is a DDL command, that is data definition language command? Now when I talk about data definition language, all the commands which are used to create the database or the tables, they are known as, they come under DDL. Like create command, it is used to create a table, okay. This is create table command, which is used to create a table, then create database command, which is used to create a database, right? Alter table command, which is also used to make changes in the schema, that is the database schema or the table. Those types of commands, they come under DDL, that is data definition language. And anything like insert, update, delete, that will come under DML, that is data manipulation language. Right? Okay. So which of the following is a DDL command?
Alter.
It is alter. Let's check the answer from this. Yes, alter is your correct answer. Name the transmission media best suitable for connecting to hilly areas.
Radio wave.
In hilly areas, we will, what would we be using? We would be using satellite communication, right? Actually the satellite communication is through microwaves only. So you will, yes, the correct answer is radio waves as well as microwaves. Radio waves, in case you are, because already we are connecting devices, okay, if you have omnidirectional antennas, through that radio waves can be propagated if we have a WiMAX antenna somewhere. And also, not WiMAX, WiMAX works on microwaves, right? So basically it would be microwaves. Then next is, identify the valid declaration of L. And options are given over here. What type of a declaration is L?
List.
It is a list. In the following code, if the following code is executed, what will be the output? Now, Anshika will answer. If the following code is executed, what will be the output of the following code? This is the code, name equals computer science with Python, print name 3:10. Do this question.
T-U-T-E-R-S-C.
We will start from 3, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. We'll start from P and we will end at 10. So this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We will end it at SC. So P, U, T, E, R, S, C. This is your output. In SQL, write the query to display the list of tables stored in a database.
Show tables.
Yes, it is show tables. Very good. write the expanded form of Wi-Fi? See, very simple question. Yes, very good. Wireless fidelity. Very simple questions are given here, right? Which of the following types of table constraints will prevent the entry of duplicate rows?
Primary key.
Yes, very good. Primary key. And one more is there, that is unique key. Here, now what is it? Which of the following types? That means you can select more than one answer. So unique and primary key. They both will not allow duplicate values to be entered, but primary key can be applied only on one field, whereas unique can be applied on more than one fields, right? Rearrange the following terms in increasing order of data transfer rates. First, bits per second, kilobits per second, megabits per second, gigabits per second, terabits per second, So this is the order. Section 2, both the case study based questions. Now here we have case study based questions. They are compulsory. Now we haven't studied these case study questions as case study questions, but we have studied these type of questions. Okay. Attempt any 4 subparts from each question. So you have to be very specific. Don't waste your time in attempting all the parts, right? Each question carries 1 mark. So we start with the first one, that is question number 22. A departmental store, My Store, is considering to maintain their inventory using SQL to store the data. As a database administrator, now you have to think that you are a database administrator. Abhay has decided that name of the database is My Store, name of the table is Store. Attributes of Store are as follows. These are the 4 fields which are there, and their data types are also given. And this is the table which is given, right? These type of questions we have already solved. Only thing, it has never been projected in the form of a case study. So first is, identify the attribute best suited to be declared as a primary key. Which attribute is best suited to be a primary key? Look at the table and tell me.
Item number.
Yes, item NO, that is your primary key. Best suited for, okay, can you tell me the reason why it should be the primary key?
So as it uniquely defines the
table. Because it uniquely defines all the fields of the table. Sorry, all the tuples of this table, right? No 2 values, no 2 tuples will have the same value for item number. Write the degree and cardinality of the table store. Now, what is degree? Degree is the number of attributes, that is fields or columns in a table. In a table, and we call the tables as relation. We had studied this last year, if you remember. Okay. And what is cardinality? It is the number of tuples, that is records, not the header row, number of tuples in a relation. Right? So this is a very, very easy and direct question. So kindly don't get confused between degree and cardinality. Degree refers to the fields, whereas cardinality refers to the records. Now look at this table and tell me what is the degree. Degree is, there are 4. How many fields are there? 4 fields are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So degree is 4. And what is the cardinality? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cardinality is 7. Okay. So this is the second question. Next is insert the following data into the attributes item NO, item name and S code respectively in the given table store. So that means you have to write an insert query over here. So you will be basically writing an insert query for this. Let me write it here. Insert into what is the table name? Store values store, and I'll be also specifying because they have specifically said only for these attributes. So item NO, item name and S code values. First one is item NO, second is notebook, so that has to be done in single quotes, and finally S code, that is 25. So this is going to be your SQL query for this. Is it clear? Next, Abhay wants to remove the table store from the database MyStore. Which command will he use for the following? He has to remove the table store. Radyum?
Ma'am, drop table?
Yes, drop table command will be used for doing that. Delete from store will delete all the tuples from the table, but it will not remove the table. Drop database will remove the entire database. That is not asked. Delete store from my store. This is not a valid SQL statement. So the correct answer is B. Now Abhay wants to display the structure of the table store, that is name of the attributes and their respective data types that he has used in the table. Write the query to display the same. Very simple question.
DESC store.
Yes, DESC store. Very good. This type of a question you have solved multiple times. Okay, you have seen these things in various questions. Right? If you remember, we used to solve questions from the back of the chapter in Sumita Arora textbook. And in that, we used to find a lot many such type of questions. Identify the cardinality, what is the degree, okay? Identify which of the fields is most suitable for being the primary key. So all these type of things, there will be questions asked from this. So this case study question is very, very scoring, as you can already see from here. So one case study question from databases you'll be getting, that is from SQL. Next case study question is based on a CSV file. So I'm just CSV files. First of all, a quick recap of CSV files we will have. So this thing has been, I have sent you the books, ebooks, everything I have sent you on that Google Classroom. So please go and download it from there. So what are CSV files? Now, CSV files are very, as I had explained earlier, they are very, very suitable for storing data and keeping it as portable as possible. Okay, the data is very much portable and it could be exchanged between applications. As you can see, if you have a spreadsheet application on your system, it readily accesses CSV files like MS Excel. If you have it on your system, it will definitely, your CSV file will open in MS Excel. Actually, it stores data in the form of comma separated values. Like, for example, I'll take the case of this record itself. 2010, comma, notebook, comma, 25. So this is what comma separated values. So each of the values are separated by a comma. Separator used is a comma. So it is very easy to convert this from one format into another. So in data sharing is a major task, so we need CSV files. It is a simple flat file in a human readable format, which is extensively used to store tabular data in a spreadsheet or database. A CSV file stores tabular data, numbers and text in plain text format. That is, you will not be able to store any kinds of images in this. Only text is allowed, whether numbers or alphabets. Files in the CSV format can be imported to and exported from programs that store data in tables, such as Microsoft Excel or OpenOffice Calc. Okay. So as already defined, it stands for comma separated values. We already know that. So 4 points here. CSV stands for comma separated values. It is used for storing tabular data in spreadsheet or database. Each record consists of fields separated by commas, which is the delimiter. Each line of the file is called a record. Why we use CSVs? The extensive use of social networking sites and their various associated applications require handling huge amounts of data which may not be structured. Okay, you can see here storing huge and exponentially growing data sets. And you can just understand it through this image. It's a very funny image of two people trying to push an elephant into a fridge, into a refrigerator. So refrigerator is considerably smaller as compared to this huge elephant. So this is the scenario. Sometimes our data sets grow to such elephantine levels that it is very difficult to fit it into a database with limited space. Processing data having complex structured, unstructured, semi-structured. Like we had studied MongoDB in the last session, if you remember. A MongoDB is basically used for storing unstructured tables. Okay, tables which don't have a fixed number of fields, right? Where everything is stored in the form of a key value pair, just like in a dictionary. So for unstructured data, we need what? CSV is very suitable for that. CSV is suitable for migration between structured and unstructured databases. Bring huge amount of data to computation unit becomes a bottleneck. So the solution to this problem is CSV, because it organizes data into a structured form, and hence the proper systematic organization of large data is done by CSV. Okay. So some advantages of CSV. Now you can just see over here, they are used in software applications ranging anywhere from online e-commerce stores to mobile apps to desktop tools. For example, Magento, an e-commerce platform, is known for its support of CSV. So some advantages: faster to handle, smaller in size, easy to generate and import onto a spreadsheet or database. It is human readable and easy to edit manually. Simple to implement and parse that is read by applications, processed by almost all existing applications. So here we will be needing two things. We'll be needing a CSV module and reading from a CSV file, writing to a CSV file. So as we had seen earlier, we have import CSV. Okay, F equals open. I'll open a CSV file and we'll do it from there only, or let it be, we'll do it from here. Okay, import CSV is the name of the module, and we are using open to open the CSV file. In which mode? Read mode. And because it is a text file only, hence we won't be using RB. We are not working on binary files. We have to create a CSV reader object, okay, a file object, and it is equal to csv.reader. So by using this reader function, we create a reader object, which is actually what it will be, a temporary memory region in the memory of the computer, in the RAM. Like this is your file which is stored on the hard disk, right? So here we have CSV file which is stored on the hard disk, and in between you have the RAM. which is a temporary memory region which stores data temporarily, and here you have a Python program, right? So this is your program, and this within RAM you have a CSV reader object. It is just like the file object which we create in case of text files and binary files, and this is associated with a name. Okay, that name over here is CSV reader. So this is a user defined identifier which is given. Right, and it takes data. Now what will happen? A Python program will send data to the reader object. Reader object will send it to the hard disk, and from hard disk the data will be fetched and kept in the reader object. Okay, one second, let me tell you that reader is only used for reading anything. That is, it's one way communication only. That is, it will only be used for reading data from the CSV file. Right, so its direction is this, and if you want to create a writer object, we will have a CSV writer object also. And we have RAM. .py, it's our program, and this is the CSV writer object. So here it will take data from the program and send it to the disk file, right? Import. So what do we write here? We simply write import CSV, and this is the user defined function. The defined function over here, to write, this is a part of the comment line only, to write or add data into the CSV file. So F equals open user.csv, and what are we going to do over here? Because it is to write as well as add data. Adding data means append. So we will write AR or RA. That is append as well as read mode. Okay. That's it. Then over here, new file reader equals CSV dot reader, new file. And here, what is it written? New file dot
close.
We are already using with open, so that close should not be here. With open mein zarurat nahi hota close ka. But still, because they have written it, so I'm writing close here, but it is not needed because we have with open over here. With open automatically closes the file after it is completed, after we come out of this program block. So I don't think anything else is written over here. We have a write row function which is used for writing into the CSV file in the form of a list object. Okay. And for reading it, we simply, now for this new file reader, that is this CSV reader object, it stores everything in the form of a list of lists. So we can easily access one list out of this major list, and we can just print them. Okay, so what they have done is they have just printed the values in this way. Provided there were only two fields, with one storing the name of the person and other storing the email address. So they have done it. So